Well, let's go over to the US now, where the former President Donald Trump was asked in front of a National Association of Black Journalists whether Kamala Harris was a diversity hire. Here's what he said.
She was always of Indian heritage, and she was only promoting Indian heritage. I didn't know she was black until a number of years ago when she happened to turn black, and now she wants to be known as black. So I don't know, is she Indian or is she black?
Well, let's bring in now the elections correspondent at the Federalist, Brianna Lyman. Thank you very much for your time. He's technically wrong there, isn't he, Donald Trump?
Yeah, Kamala Harris is half Indian, half Jamaican. That being said, I think what Donald Trump was trying to allude to is the fact that Kamala Harris is trying to play up half of her heritage while ignoring the other half to appeal to obviously black voters, because that is a voting bloc that Joe Biden was actually losing. You saw a lot of black voters who had really low enthusiasm rates with Joe Biden, and Biden and the Democrats were headed for a 2016 repeat, in which black voters in particular were so disillusioned with Hillary Clinton that they chose the couch as a third option, right? It wasn't Hillary, Trump, it was the couch. And Democrats risked that. So now they have to try to win back those voters. And I think that might've been what Donald Trump was trying to convey, whether or not he did that the best way. That's up for, you know, everybody's own interpretation.
Yeah. Look, it's been said that Kamala Harris brings out the worst in Donald Trump's instincts, that he often makes sexist comments about her. And we, I guess we're starting to see, or not necessarily sexist, but inappropriate comments about her. And we're starting to see that. Do you think that proposition is right, that the way he's responding to her isn't presenting him in the best light?
Well, I would disagree a little bit. I would say that I have not heard Donald Trump say anything that was, you know, sexist, misogynist. And the problem is that in America, you know, there's not a ton of conservative outlets, both on media, both on TV and in print. And so they're kind of crafting the narrative. They have been known to lie. They're still lying. They're lying, actually, as we speak right now. I've read a dozen articles in the past 24 hours that really distorts what actually happened yesterday at the conference. When it comes to Kamala Harris, though, I think she does one thing. She agitates Donald Trump, and not for him to say anything that's sexist, misogynist, racist, but she gets him to speak. And if you notice a difference between the debate back in June to when Joe Biden dropped out, Donald Trump was quiet. This is a man who was tempered. And we know Donald Trump, he's never this way. And it was working for him. People were actually saying, where's Donald Trump? Like, why isn't he giving us news to focus on? We have to actually focus on the Democrats. Kamala is different. Donald Trump is now kind of forced to go out on the defense because Kamala is more active on the campaign trail. Kamala is taking hits at Donald Trump that Biden wasn't literally able to do because he was cognitively impaired.
And let's have a look at one of those hits. Here was Kamala Harris responding to what Trump had to say.
And it was the same old show. The divisiveness and the disrespect. And let me just say, the American people deserve better. The American people deserve better.